Guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to be filming today because it's Boxycharm time. And if you guys don't know, I do Boxycharm unboxings on this channel every month, and I am subscribed to their base box and their premium box. Base box is $25 a month and premium is $35 a month. But in base, you get 5 full-size products, and in premium, you get, I think, around 6 or 7 full-size products. But every month, I come here, and I review and show you guys the products in the box. Is it worth it or is it not? I have my box, my premium box. If you guys have not seen my base box unboxing, I'll link it down in the description box for you guys because I already reviewed that box and I actually ended up getting this box kind of late. So yeah, I'm finally reviewing it. And as you can tell, I already have my eyebrows done and they're concealed and everything. And I'm gonna get into the video. I'm gonna start off by priming my eyelids with the P. Louise base. And this is in Rumor 1. And I love this base. If you guys don't know, it's like one of my favorites. And I'm actually just going to be placing that on my eyelid. And I'm going to just dab out the product and spread it. I know I look crazy, but once we get the makeup, it's going to look so bomb. So we have our eyelids already primed, and the reason I have my eyelids primed is because we have an eyeshadow palette in our box. I have my box opened, and here is the pamphlet that you get in the boxes each month, and it just gives you information on the products in the box and the pricing and stuff like that. And I am so excited about this product, you guys, because I ended up getting the Ofra palette in my premium box, and this is what it looks like. It looks super, super beautiful. I'm gonna take the protector off. Look at these colors, you guys. Like, you get a pretty warm orange shade, or it's more like a reddish orange shade. Then you get this beautiful shimmery mint color, which I am going to use on my eyelid because that is the color that is screaming my name. And you get these beautiful neutral colors, some more shimmers, and you get obviously one of their infamous highlighters, which is this like wheel right here. You can use the highlighter like I don't know how to explain it. Like, for example, if you want to use like the white one, you could just like dip your eyeshadow you could dip your highlighting brush into each separate color if you just want to use the separate color that you want. But you can also mix the entire colors all together, and it makes like a really, really beautiful combo. They also included a bronzer in here as well as a blush, but obviously you can use the bronzer also as an eyeshadow if you want, as well as the blush. But I think this is such a pretty, pretty palette. When I saw it as a spoiler, I got so excited because I don't own any of Ofra's eyeshadows, so I was like really curious to try out their formula. But I do own their highlighters, and I would say like back then when I would wear highlighter, I actually really, I liked them. I thought they were really blinding and they were obviously stunning. But now I'm more of like a person that doesn't like wearing highlighter anymore, especially since I have texture. I just feel like highlighter emphasizes texture, and I just don't like that type of look anymore. So I go more for like more subtle highlighters, or I either go matte. That's just my preference. Okay, you guys, so I am back, and I did do this eye off camera because I just wanted to see where I was gonna go, or like what I was gonna come up with. And originally I was gonna do like a half cut crease, but instead I was like, you know what? I'm gonna do a halo eye because I really don't do halo eyes. If you guys follow me on Instagram where I post like all my makeup looks, I really don't do halo eyes. And the reason I don't do them is because I just feel like I am not good at them. I feel like I still need to practice just like cutting the crease and like blending the outer edges and stuff. But with like the mid shade, I just thought that it would be really, really pretty as a halo eye. So that is what I did on this eye. And I did use some glitter eyeshadow, and it's actually not included in the box. This is something that I just wanted to add to the look to make it more prettier and more out there. But I used the e.l.f. liquid eyeshadow, and this is in the color Disco Queen. And these are actually like a dupe for the Stila ones. And if not, they're better. And for the price, it's like chef's kiss. Anyways, I'm gonna get to how to achieve this eye look. And excuse my hand motions. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing, but bear with me. So, like I said, I'm gonna go in with this color right here, this brown sh or not brown, orange transition shade. But first, I'm going to blend out the crease that I have because I've had this eyelid primed for a minute. Please mind the noise that our dog is making because he likes to move his bed around to get comfy. So I'm gonna start by tapping the shade right here like this. And I'm gonna start to blend. Okay, so after blending this shadow, I have it looking like this. This is what this eye looks like already with our color blended out. And it blended out pretty good. And the shadows are pigmented, as you can tell. So now I'm actually gonna go in with this smaller brush, and it's more like tapered, Morphe M518. And I'm going to go back into the palette, and I'm going to dip into this color right here, and I'm going to place that right here on the outer V, or like outer corner of our eye. And I'm going to kind of go into our crease like this, and I'm going to start blending this shadow upward around my crease to give it like more of a density to our eye look. And you don't want to keep the shadow too up because when you're going to blend, the color is going to move. So you want to kind of keep your brush or your shadow kind of low and then just like blend from there. That's kind of like a little trick that I learned from keeping like the color from not going too far up. Also building it to my liking. So this whole time that I'm gonna do this eye look, you guys, I'm just gonna be building the color and also blending. So it's gonna be like a lot of back and forth. If you guys like watch my other videos, when I do eyeshadow, that's just the technique that I do. I always add or pack on eyeshadow and then I blend, pack on eyeshadow and then blend, and that's just how I get the best result for eye looks. And then I'm going to be placing this right on our inner eyelid so that when you do the halo eye, both outer parts of the eye are pigmented with eyeshadow, if that makes any sense. Go back into our Makeup Shack brush and grab more of that mustardy orange shade. And I'm just going to be blending the edges of our reddish shade so it could all look really blended and no harsh edges. And I'm just going to go in circular motions. So I feel like that's blended out pretty nicely. I'm gonna take a sip of my coffee, which is already melted. I mean, the ice melted and stuff. So the next step, I'm going to basically start cutting the crease for my halo. So I'm gonna grab my concealer brush that I used to cut my crease and conceal my eyebrows. And I already have some of the P. Louise base on my hand. So I'm just gonna grab some of that. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to place the base in the middle of my eye. Drag it down just like that. And when I look up, like, I already have a clue where I'm going to draw the line. So that is how I cut the crease, and I'm just going to pat out the base to make it more smoother, and then with my finger, like this one right here, I'm going to like pat the edges of the base, because when we're going to blend out our matte shade, you don't want there to be like a line from the base and having it looking patchy. We're gonna grab this really small detailed brush. It's from Makeup Shack. It's the T53, I think. And we're gonna grab the orange shade and the brown shade. Not brown, why do I keep calling it brown? The mustardy orange shade. So this one right here. And we're just gonna basically again tap it and then blend it. Same to here. Now we're gonna take our flat brush and we're gonna dip into the mint shade. And we're gonna place that where we laid our base. So the middle part of our eye. And look at this mint green shade. It is so beautiful. I love it. It's so icy. And we're gonna go back into the small brush. Just grab a little bit of the orange shade. We are going to take our e.l.f. glitter, which again is not in the box for Boxycharm. And I'm just gonna take this Morphe flat brush and I'm just gonna grab some of that on here. I'm going to place that on top of the green shade just to give it a little more shimmer. I feel like that green shade, it's really metallic and really foiled and it's really beautiful, but I just want it to be like super glittery, you know. And I'm gonna let that dry down and I'm gonna go in with my Hank and Henry blackety liner, and I'm actually just gonna do a very thin liner just so that when I put my lashes can like blend in more easily, but I'm not gonna do a wing. I'm gonna apply my lashes and I'm actually gonna do my foundation, and once I'm done with that, I'll come back and I will show you guys and talk through the rest of the products in our box. So I'm finally back with my foundation, concealer, and contour all done, and we're actually gonna get into the next item in our box. The next product is actually a face product. It's the Fenty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Setting Powder. I have been wanting this powder ever since it came out. I've been wanting it And I just never really, I don't know, something just of me didn't want to spend that much money on a setting powder when I already have a ton of setting powders to go through. But I actually got it in the same color that I wanted, in the color butter. And I didn't know, you guys, if I was going to get this in my box, because this was actually, I think, one of the choice items, and I didn't even get to pick my choice for this month's box because I just totally forgot. So I was like really, really praying that I would get the powder. But since Boxycharm also does add-ons, I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna buy the powder for a discounted price. So I ended up getting two of them. I actually put the other one in my makeup kit, and I'm actually going to try this one out on myself since this is my powder. This is what the packaging looks like, and it's a very big powder. It has a ton of product, and I'm actually going to take the seal off. I'm so excited to try this powder because I've heard really, really good things about it, and I've just like wanted it. I'm going to blend out any creases that I have. I'm gonna grab my powder sponge and set my under eye. And this actually has a fragrance which smells pretty nice, but hopefully it doesn't break me out. So this shade is pretty good for brightening under the eye, or like setting the under eye, but I don't think I'll use it for all of my face because it'll just wash me out. I've heard like really good things about this powder, but at the same time, people don't like the powder because of the fragrance, and they say that even after wearing it all day, they can still smell the fragrance. But it smells like perfume to me, like a really nice perfume. I'm actually gonna let it sit on my skin, and I'm going to grab my banana powder from Dermablend, and I'm actually gonna use this to set my face, the rest of my face. Just a tiny little bit of powder, not too much. Probably should have gotten the banana powder instead. It was like an all over powder. I don't know, let me guys know down below if you guys have tried this powder, the Fenty one. Do you guys love it? Do you guys hate it? I would really love to know. And if you got on your Boxycharm, same thing. Did you guys enjoy this powder, or do you guys disliked it? So I'm not going to remove the powder from our under eyes. I'm just gonna press the powder in our nose into my nose skin. What do you think about the powder? It looks really nice under my under eyes. I feel like it made it look airbrushed. It didn't get rid of the brightness or anything like that, so that's a pretty good thing. I do like the powder so far. I'm going to keep doing my makeup, and then at the end I'm actually going to take a closer look at my makeup and let you guys know if I really, really love it. But so far it's doing pretty good. I'm going to finish my face makeup because the rest of the products are actually skincare. So I'm gonna do my face makeup real quick, and then I'll come back to share my final thoughts. This is what my makeup is looking like today. So I added my lip combo, which wasn't anything from the box. It actually was the NYX Professional Makeup Soudaire Matte Lip Liner in Downtown Beauty. It is the perfect brown lip liner with Those of Colors liquid lipstick and Let's Cuddle. And on top for gloss, I actually tested out the Alamar Cosmetics lip glosses, and this is actually in the shade Coqueta. And I thought I wasn't gonna like it, but it's actually a really, really pretty color, so I am liking it so far. So that's my lip combo. I did go ahead and basically just put on some gel liner and actually use the ColourPop gel liner, And this is just like in this, I think this is, oh, it's called Icebreaker. So this is the liner I use from ColourPop and Icebreaker. And I basically just used the mint shade from the Ofra palette. And I just like set it, the liner, and then I like swatched it out. So that way you can see the blue Alamar better. Lashes, I actually, I'm also testing out these new lashes. It's from Glamnetic. And these are basically magnetic lashes, and these are in the style Bella. I did get these in a Boxycharm in my base box, which I don't think it was like a couple boxes ago, but it's like my first time wearing them, and I absolutely love them so far, and they were super easy to apply. So now for the rest of the products in our box. So like I mentioned, I only got three makeup products. So it was the Ofra palette, which we already went through, and it was actually the Fenty powder, which I really liked as well. And I actually forgot that I had this as a mascara, but it's the Fenty Beauty full frontal mascara. So this is supposed to give you like volume and like lifting your lashes. And this is actually one of their newest mascaras, I believe. I didn't test it out because I also, like, one, I forgot about it, and second, I also have a lot of mascaras, and I don't really go through mascaras like that, so I kind of don't want to open it and, like, you know, have it go dry out or something like that. So I'm really happy that I got this. The rest of the products, so is skincare. So I actually got the Summer Fridays Jet Lag Mask. So this was actually a very popular mask, like around social media, I think, or YouTube. But I've been wanting to try this because I've heard really good things about this mask and how it helps with like jet lag. So I am gonna use it one day, and I'll let you guys know how I like it. But I am super excited that I actually got this product. For the upcoming product is from Ren, and it's their Perfect Canvas Clean Jelly Oil Cleanser. So this is a jelly cleanser. I don't think I've ever used a jelly cleanser before. So this is supposed to help with removing makeup. It also helps with removing SPF and pollution. So this is gonna leave your skin super squeaky and clean. It also has sunflower seed extract to protect the skin's natural moisture barrier and prevent dryness. It has meadow foam seed oil to help replenish and restore the skin's barrier with essential fatty acids, omega 3 and 6. So I can't wait to use this once I run out of my other cleansers. The last product in my box is from PMD. It's the Silver Pure TM, and it's basically a cloth that you use to remove your makeup, and it's kind of similar to the makeup eraser one. If you guys know about that one, you guys know that it's a super popular cloth remover. Everybody loves it. I have tried the mini one of the makeup eraser, and I didn't really like it. I just felt like it didn't really work. But, you know, I am going to give this a shot to see how it works out. I do like using the other one, though, to, like, remove, like, my clay masks. I just find it easier for that purpose. So, hopefully, this actually works better than the makeup eraser. So, I'm going to try this out one day. That is pretty much it for my box, you guys. So we tried everything out, and I would say like my top products that I really like are the Ofra palette for sure, and I would say the Fenty Beauty powder was good as well. It does have a strong scent, but I don't mind it, and hopefully it doesn't break me off from the fragrance, but I'm crossing my fingers. But I really do like the powder. The eyeshadow powder is like my number one top favorite. It's so good. The formula is amazing. For the Fenty Beauty Powder though, I would probably get it in the shade darker just if I want to use it to set my entire face. But other than that, I really, really like the powder. And in total for my box, I did tally everything up, and my box this month came up to $205, which is a crazy amount of money. Like I always say in my Boxycharm videos, this is why I love Boxycharm, because you get an amazing value from your boxes, amazing product and skincare for only a small amount of money. So for the box, it's like $35 plus taxes, so I'm paying like 37 something, which isn't a lot, you guys. Compared to $205, it's a bomb ass deal. And I would say that this month they honestly nailed it with the box for premium. Everything in here I actually wanted and I actually got, and I absolutely love it. I would definitely recommend it to you guys. And that is gonna be for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and make sure you guys subscribe to my video, hit the bell button, that way you guys could get notified whenever I upload, and give this video a huge thumbs up. Comment down below if you guys like any of these products, or what did you get in your Boxycharm, and any video ideas. And I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye!